If God, why evil? That's one of the most common questions I hear, and one of the most challenging. Often the questioner has looked around at the world and seen the suffering and injustice and pain and evil, and concluded, how can there possibly be a God who is all-powerful and all-good given the state of things? But when I hear that question, I often want to respond to the person asking it, have you thought about the nature of the word evil for a moment? You see, inherent in the word evil is the idea of oughtness. When you say that something is evil, you're saying it ought not to have happened. It ought not to have been allowed. Look at what Hitler did. Look at what the Khmer Rouge did. Look at what happened in Rwanda. Look at the violence in the Middle East. That ought not to be the case. But the problem is this. If there is no God, if we live in a purely atheistic universe, then everything that happens simply happens. There is no ought to anything. Everything is simply governed by the blind, impersonal, uncaring forces of time plus chance plus natural selection. Nothing ought to be the case. In fact, the very best you can say as an atheist is you don't like something. I don't like murder. I don't like ethnic cleansing. I don't like rape. But those are just my personal preferences. You can't call them evil because there is no way the world ought to be. Back in the late 1970s, the atheist philosopher Arthur Leff of Yale University wrote a very often quoted essay exploring this very area. He said, if you remove God, as atheists like to do, there's really only two places that you can base morality. Either every human being gets to make up morality for themselves, and then the problem is you have 7 billion little godlets running around all disagreeing with each other. Or we agree that the state gets to decide what is right and wrong, and then you have the tyranny of the majority. But in either case, whether it's the state or individuals inventing the rules, he said any time anybody looks at you and says you ought to do something, you can look them squarely in the eye and say, yeah, says who? And so Arthur Leff, the atheist philosopher, said that all moral claims, all talk of good and evil, if there is no God, basically crash and flounder and sink on the rock, on the reef of atheism. We can't get beyond personal preference. But the thing is, we can't live that way. We all inherently know that there are such things as good and evil. When we see injustice or murder or violence, our instinctive reaction is to say, no, it's wrong, it's evil, it ought not to be the case. But that primal cry that comes out from within us only makes sense if there is a God behind the universe who actually gives a foundation, a ground to good and evil and genuine morality. So the paradox is, the moment that you raise the problem of evil, thinking you can use it to dismiss God, you actually end up arguing to God. The presence of evil doesn't lead us to atheism. It leads us to the recognition that there is a God and there are real moral values. And then it raises the next question. Okay, if God does exist, if I can't escape that, what has that God done about evil and suffering? And my word is that's something that Christianity has a lot to say about. But that's perhaps an answer for another time.